If you've ever created a basic static block in WordPress, you're probably all too familiar with the error message in the block editor that says, this block contains unexpected or invalid content. Your gut reaction is probably to write off static blocks as more trouble than they're worth and only to create dynamic blocks. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate some of the differences, advantages, and disadvantages of static versus dynamic blocks. Then I'm going to show an alternative to static blocks that gives you some of the best of both worlds. This is a new feature being introduced in the Pinegrow web editor, and it's something I'm very excited about. I'm Adam Lowe, president of Peak Performance Digital. You can learn more about me at adamlowe.io or my agency's website at peakperformancedigital.com. If you find content like this helpful, I'd love it if you could give me a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button. Let's start off with the basics. In WordPress's block guide, they say that a static block is used to insert HTML content into the post and save it with that post, and that dynamic blocks build the content on the fly using PHP when rendered on the front end. In very simple terms, you can think of a static block as being basic HTML code that's written once and stored inside the WordPress database, then delivered directly to the browser. If you look in the WordPress database, you'll notice that the post stores the contents of the card as well as its HTML markup. Compare that with a dynamic block, which is more like traditional PHP, where the server processes the code each time it's requested, then delivers the resulting HTML to the browser. Again, here in the database, you can see that the block stores the content we entered in the block properties, but if you look closely, you'll notice that there's no HTML markup or indication of the dynamic data portion of the block, since all that comes from the block's PHP file. In the end, though, your browser still gets regular HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, but the way WordPress stores and delivers it to you is different for each type. In practice, static blocks have a few advantages. First, content delivered by a static block has the opportunity to be much faster than a traditional WordPress PHP or dynamic block. That's because it's just simple HTML and it's delivered directly without any extra server processing. Also, from a content editor's perspective, a static block has a huge advantage over a dynamic block, since its content can be edited inline inside the WordPress block editor. A dynamic block, on the other hand, doesn't give you that capability. It forces you to edit the contents in the block's properties panel. Most of the core WordPress blocks in the text, media, and design categories that you use to write content are static blocks, by the way. One of the biggest downsides to using static blocks is that any change to the structure of the block's HTML will cause that dreaded unexpected or invalid content error in the block editor. Even something as simple as adding a class can trigger this message. In some ways, this isn't as bad as it seems, but in other ways, it's potentially disastrous. You see, when that message appears, nothing changes for visitors on the front end of the website, even if you edit the page as long as that block isn't touched. Again, that's because the content and structure are stored as HTML. The problem, though, is that you aren't going to see any of the changes to that block unless you click the Attempt Block Recovery button on each instance of the block throughout the site. Think about that for a minute. As long as the static block is only used on one page or a very limited number of pages, doing block recovery isn't a big deal, especially since the structure of your blocks isn't going to be changing often anyway. The real issue, though, is when you're creating a block to use throughout the site in an unknown number of places. Hunting down each instance of a particular block can be next to impossible to do manually, especially on large sites. And even then, you still have to recover each block and save each page that uses it. And this brings us to dynamic blocks. WordPress has a page on its site titled Static versus Dynamic Blocks, What's the Difference? It talks about two primary use cases for dynamic blocks. The most common and obvious case is when you want to display content such as post fields dynamically from the database. A great example would be something like a post grid that pulls titles, excerpts, and featured images from posts. The other use case that they mention is when updates to a block code should be immediately shown on the website without any user interaction. This is the issue we discussed earlier, that in a static block would trigger the unexpected or invalid content error. But that's not an issue with dynamic blocks, since they're always going to check for and use the latest code each time they're viewed on the front end or the back end of the site. You're probably thinking to yourself, why not use dynamic blocks for everything? Aside from not taking advantage of the speed benefit inherent with static blocks, dynamic blocks also present a few challenges to content editors. First, editor performance takes a pretty big hit with dynamic blocks. Unlike the front end where dynamic data is often cached, the block editor takes much longer to load both the content and the controls for a dynamic block. Secondly, and more importantly, dynamic blocks don't offer the same seamless inline editing experience that you get with static blocks. Instead, you generally have to go to the block sidebar controls to edit the attributes such as text formatting and images. So that begs the question, how do commercial plugins handle this dilemma? When I update Generate Blocks, Cadence, or other block plugins, I'm not faced with having to do block recovery. Normally, commercial plugins will use complex JavaScript to handle all these issues of upgrading blocks, allowing inline dynamic block editing, and more. This makes sense for commercial plugins since they're all making a very small number of flexible blocks that they sell to thousands of users. But for you and I who are making sites for ourselves and our clients, it just isn't practical. WordPress offers a solution called block deprecation. This avoids the errors in the editor, but it doesn't actually update the block unless the page is refreshed and saved. Plus, it's a pretty big hassle to implement. Again, though, this is fine if you're only making limited changes to a small number of blocks, but it gets unwieldy pretty quickly for the rest of us. Thankfully, there is a third option for blocks with static data. It combines the ease of editing offered by static blocks with the resilience of dynamic blocks. In this scenario, the block uses React for the WordPress block editor, then uses PHP to render the blocks when they're displayed on the front end. This means no more block recovery, it means you can edit content inline, and blocks are always displayed up to date without having to resave posts where they're used. Here's the catch though. This also means that the same block essentially needs to be created both ways in JavaScript and PHP with slight differences between them. That's certainly not practical for most developers or build processes. Luckily, we have Pinegrow's new hybrid blocks. In addition to Pinegrow's dynamic, regular, and ACF blocks, Pinegrow now offers the ability to create hybrid blocks. You can set hybrid blocks as your project's default block type, create a new block as a hybrid block, and even convert existing static blocks to hybrid blocks, just by selecting it from a drop-down menu. This is seriously cool stuff, and something I've been looking forward to for a long time. With it, I'll feel much better about making general-purpose blocks that I can install on a site and feel comfortable using, knowing that I won't have to play the Find the Broken Block game later on. There is no way I can do justice to the technical details of these hybrid blocks, so instead, I'm going to point you to Pinegrow's own documentation. They have a great overview video and examples of demonstrating how these hybrid blocks work, how to use them, and some troubleshooting tips for converting your existing static and dynamic blocks to hybrid. So, let's do a quick recap. Static blocks are best for static content and custom blocks that will only be used on a very limited number of pages. One example might be a pricing table that only gets used once or twice. Their content and structure are stored as HTML. They have potential speed advantages over PHP-based blocks and templates. They offer a nice inline editing experience, but they're prone to needing block repair and they don't offer any dynamic data. Dynamic blocks are the only option for you if you want to render dynamic data from WordPress. They have to be processed by the PHP server before being delivered to the browser, so they aren't quite as efficient as static blocks, but with proper caching, the differences can be pretty small. Dynamic blocks do not need to be repaired when you modify them since they're loaded each time they're viewed, but the biggest downside is that they don't allow you to edit content inline, so you'll have to use the block properties in the sidebar. Hybrid blocks are great for static content, especially with blocks that are going to be widely used throughout the site. For example, a generic custom block to create an icon list might get used throughout the site on pages, posts, and custom post types. Their content is still stored as static data, but the structure is generated dynamically, so you don't need to worry about having to repair the block each time you make a change to its code. Hybrid block performance on the front end is similar to a regular dynamic block, but unlike dynamic blocks, they don't have any performance problems in the block editor, and their content can be edited inline. The biggest downside to hybrid blocks is that they're a massive headache to create and maintain unless you have a tool like Pinegrow to handle it for you. I hope this gave you some insight into the different types of WordPress blocks and why you might choose one over the other. All three types have their place, so it's up to us to understand what to use for each individual situation. If you want to learn more about creating custom WordPress blocks, check out the links in the description below. There I've listed several resources from WordPress and Kinsta's excellent block development tutorial. Of course, if you want to bypass all that technical stuff and get right down to creating blocks the easy and visual way, be sure to check out the Pinegrow web editor. It's my tool of choice, and I can't even begin to tell you how much time it's saved and how much has improved the quality of the projects I deliver to my clients. And as always, if you found this video helpful, please like and subscribe or leave a comment down below, and I'll see you next time.